the real meaning of life is when you come in touch with a personal relationship with the one who created you. And the plan of salvation, which is available to every single human being, whether you're in prison, whether you're an accountant, whether you're a pipe fitter, it doesn't matter. Whether you're NASCAR, a super successful NASCAR executive, it doesn't make any difference. It's the same plan of salvation. And it's simply this, that God in the beginning made you, and he made you in his image. He created you. The only alternative to that is we came out of the primordial soup and we're nothing but grown-up germs. I don't think most people can't cope with that. I mean, we know there's a God. God made us, he revealed himself to us. He gave us a free will. That's the essence of being human. He made us in his image, so we have a free will. We can choose right, we can choose wrong. And the fact of the matter is that the human will is disposed to do wrong more than it is to do right, because it's part of our perverse nature that we are rebellious. And this goes back to the Garden of Eden when the original humans rebelled against God. And that temptation is always there in every life. And we begin to think of ourselves being the center of life instead of God being the center of life. That's the big obstacle to coming into the kingdom. But the fact is that even though God knows that we have sinned and fallen short of his glory, because every human being has, he's made provision for that by sending his son to die on the cross in our place, taking our punishment that we deserve on himself, that we can be free. And then we can live as followers of Christ. And it's that invitation is available to every single human being. Now, that doesn't mean you're suddenly going to be wealthy and prosperous and successful. You may do what I did. I came to Christ, and within a year and a half after I did, I was in prison. And odd thing is, I was probably happier then and at more peace in prison than I'd been in the White House. Most people will hear that and they won't understand it. It's the paradox of the faith. Once you're at peace with God, you can go through anything.